गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ क्लास ऑन द डायग्नोस्टिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ सम ऑफ द कमर्शियली इम्पोर्टेंट फिन फिशेस। ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द इंडियन मेजर कार्प्स। ओके, सो यू हैव गॉन थ्रू द मटेरियल व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेंड टू यू पीपल।
यस मैम।
ओके, so today we are going to have we will discuss in the detail about the what are the diagnostic characters. Okay, so anyone can define me what does mean diagnostic character? Anyone what does mean diagnostic character?
The characters which can differentiate.
Which can differentiate what?
Different species.
Which can differentiate different species. Okay. The diagnostic means a character that can be specific to a specific or specific to a particular thing. Okay. So if I'm talking about the diagnostic character of the economical species, means these are the character which is unique to that particular species. Means with those character, with those set of characters, you can say that ki yes, this particular specimen is belong to a particular species. Okay. There are several characters which occurs in the fishes are common. Okay. Suppose if I'm talking about, suppose scales, presence of cycloid scales. Okay. So presence of the cycloid scale is a very common character of all the fishes which occurs in the order Cypriniformis. Okay, or if I'm talking about the scaleless fishes, this is a very common character for all the fishes which belongs to the order Siluriformis. Okay, so this is similar, but there, even though they share some character which make them to be in a one group. But even though individual species have some character at species level that make them different from other species. Okay. So those character which make them unique is known as a diagnostic character. Today we are going to take, actually in the syllabus, we are going to take the diagnostic character of commercially important fishes of freshwater and marine. Okay. So today we will take some of the important, economically important fishes of the freshwater, and then we are going to take in next class we are take some of the marine fishes. Okay. So today we are going to concentrate on the major economically important species, that is Indian major carps. Okay. So today we are going to discuss the diagnostic character of three species, that is Indian major carps, Labio rohita, Sirenus smregla, and Katla katla. And then we'll also take one more species which is of very important in respect to the northern India and in particularly the state of Bihar. Okay, so today we are also take we'll discuss or study the diagnostic character of state fish of Bihar. Which is the state fish of Bihar? Anyone?
Clarius petricus.
Very good. The Clarius petricus, commonly known as magur, is the state fish of Bihar. So it is very economically important fish. It is a very preferred fish by the consumer in this region. So we will take three species, Indian major carps, Labio rohita, Sirenus smregla, and Katla katla, and then we will take the state fish of the Bihar, Clarius petricus. Okay, so first we will start with the IMCs. Okay, as I have told, today we are going to discuss the freshwater fishes of the economical importance of our country. So here we are going to take today the three fishes, the Katla katla, Labio rohita, and Sirenus smregla. So we will take first the diagnostic character of Labio rohita. Okay, so the very first character is the body is elongated and the highest body length. Okay, when you were here, you in the practical you have measured the head length, body depth, the standard length, total length. You remember all those, na? All those characters. Okay, so if you talk about Labio rohita, the highest body depth means the highest body depth is at the point from where the dorsal fin starts. Okay, so here you can see So this is the reason from, this is a standard fish diagram, okay? The diagram of particular is a standard fish, okay, for morphometry. So here, just see, this is the point where the dorsal fin starts, okay? So in case of labiorhoita, so from here to here, from here to here, the highest body depth in labiorhoita means if we measure the body depth from here to here or here to here or from here to here or from head region to here, so the highest body depth is from the insertion point of the dorsal fin, okay? Then the dorsal fin rays, the 14 to 16, this is also a diagnostic character of labiorhoita, and the mouth position is terminal. You remember in the practical class as well as in the theory class, we have discussed different type of mouth present in the fishes. You remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What are those types?
Yes, ma'am. What are superior?
Inferior, superior.
Superior and terminal.
Terminal and subterminal. Okay. So you are also going through the one of the course principle of aquaculture and some other related courses, okay, where you have must have studied that composite fish culture, is it? Yes or no? In composite fish culture, what we used to do, we used to culture many species together. Okay, so this Indian major carps, rohu, katla, mrigal, these three species can be cultured together. Okay, why they can be cultured in the same point? Why? Because they have three different zone of feeding in the, okay, one feed on the top layer, another feed on the column, and the third one feeds in the bottom layer. Okay, so one is the surface feeder, another one is bottom. The column feeder, and third one is the bottom feeder. Okay, so because they feed in different columns of the pond, so they have different mouth morphology which is adapted for the feeding in different columns or different zones or different layers of the water body. Okay, so because labiorhoita feeds in which zone? Anyone? Labiorhoita? As I am telling, the mouth position in the labiorhoita is terminal. Means labiorhoita feeds in which zone?
Middle zone.
That is known as a column, okay, column feeder. So because they have because they have to feed in the column, so they need the terminal mouth, okay? So the mouth position is terminal. Then it will be always easy to remember when you remember in which zone which species used to feed, okay? Katla feed on the surface, they have superior mouth. Rohu feeds in a column, so they have the terminal mouth, and the mrigal feed in the bottom, so they have the inferior mouth. Okay, so because labiorhoita, it feeds in the column of the middle zone, and they have the terminal mouth. This type of mouth morphology help them to feed in the column zone. Okay, so now then the snout is depressed and projecting beyond the jaws without any lateral lobes. Okay, then the interorbital space is convex. You know what is interorbital space? The space between two eyes. Okay, in the fishes, the position of the eyes is on both the side, on lateral side. Okay, if you see the body of the fish, majority of the fishes have the location of the eye lateral side because they have the which type of vision? Monocular or biocular vision?
Biocular
vision. Okay, so their eyes are on two sides, two lateral sides. So the space between eyes is known as the interorbital space. So the interorbital space in labiorhoita is convex in shape. Okay, then the next character is lips are thick and fringed. Fringed means they have a kind of membranous structure around the lips. Okay. So here we see in this slide, this is the typical morphology of the fringed lips in the rohu. Is it clear now? This is the typical morphology of the fringed lips. So they have the thick lips which are fringed. The post-labial groove is continuous. The post-labial groove means some fishes have a smaller or the shallow groove behind the lips. Okay, So behind the lips, that's why they are known as the postlabial. Okay, so some fishes have this shallow groove behind the lips. So here, labiorhoita also have the postlabial groove, which is continuous in nature. Then the pair of short maxillary bubbles, they have a pair of maxillary bubbles. Then teeth on the jaws are absent. When we were studying the diagnostic character of the order Cypriniformes, this was a very important character to define the order Cypriniformes, means toothless jaw. Is it? Yes. So labiorhoita, it also belongs to the order Cypriniformes. So their jaws doesn't bear any type of teeth. Okay, but yes, they have pharyngeal teeth. Then the lateral line scale, the scale which is present on the lateral line. Okay, so in the labiorhoita, the lateral line is complete and the lateral line scales are 40 in number. And now the fin formula. D represents what?
Dorsal fin.
So Roman numerical represents what?
Hard rays.
Hard rays.
Arabic?
Soft rays.
Soft rays.
P defines?
Pectoral.
Pectoral.
Good. V define?
Pelvic.
Pelvic.
So these are the important diagnostic characters of this species, labiorhoita. Okay. So here I have shown the terminal mouth. Okay, or this type of mouth is present in the rohu. Okay. So now the taxonomic classification of the labiorhoita. This is the taxonomic classification of the labiorhoita. This belongs to the order Cypriniformes, family Cyprinidae, genus Labio, and species Rhoita. And from phylum to the infra class, this is the classification we are going to study for the fin fishes as per the Nelson's 1994 classification. Okay, this is the taxonomic classification based on the Nelson's classification. Okay, so from here to here, it is same for all the teleost fin fishes, and this fishes belongs to the order Cypriniformes, the family Cyprinidae, genus Labio, and species Labiorhoita. Now, the diagnostic character of the another IMC, that is Serenus Megala. So this you have also done in the practical class, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so, the very first diagnostic character of the Serenus Megala is the body depth is equal to the head length. Okay, so if you used to measure the head length is from here to here. Okay, the head length is from here to here and the body depth is from here to here. So in this Serenus Megala, the body depth and head length is almost equal. Okay. Then the snout is blunt and the mouth position is inferior. Why their mouth position is inferior?
Bottom feeder.
They are bottom feeders.
It's in the bottom. They are bottom feeder. Okay. So the mouth position in the Serenus Megala is inferior. Mouth is broad. Upper lip is complete, but lower lip is indistinct. If the mouth position is inferior, the upper lip will be more developed, okay? And the lower lip will be less developed or indistinct. If the mouth position is superior, the upper lip is indistinct or less developed, lower lip is more developed or complete, okay? And in case of terminal, both the lips are almost same in appearance and structure. So here, the mouth position is inferior. So the mouth is broad and the upper lip is complete, but lower lip is indistinct. They have a short pair of the rostral barbel. Teeth are absent in jaw, but pharyngeal teeth are arranged in three rows in the pharynx. Okay. Now the gill racker on first. You know what is gill racker? Gill racker. Gill racker is a filamentous.
Yes, ma'am. Uske piche mein wo lining tha.
Yes, that is rachis. Okay, if we talk about the gill arc, one side have the gill filaments and this opposite sides have pointed or filamentous or teeth-like structure, which is known as gill rackers. Okay, so in Strenus Megala, the number of gill rackers on first gill varies from 40 to 49 in number, and this is diagnostic. Okay, then the height of the fin fish is equal to the body depth, dorsal fin. Okay, if we take the height, if we to open, okay, the dorsal fin to the max position, and when we take the height of the dorsal fin, the height of the dorsal fin will be equal to the body depth of the fish, and then the pectoral fin is shorter than the head length. Caudal fin is deeply forked, and lateral line scales varies from 42 to 45. Okay, and this is the fin formula. D 3 are the hard rays, 12 to 13 are the soft rays. In pelvic, 1 is the hard rays, 17 are soft rays. In ventral or the, sorry, this is pectoral. In ventral or pelvic, 1 is the hard and the 8 are the soft rays. A is the anal, 3 hard and 5 soft rays. Okay. So now the classification of, this is the taxonomic position of Strenus Megala. This is very same to the Labiorhoeta, only difference in the name of genus and species name. Okay, here you can see that their caudal fin is deeply forked. Okay, when you compare the image of the Strenus Megala with the Labiorhoeta and Katlakatla, you won't fork such a deep cut in the caudal fin. Okay, now the diagnostic character of the third IMC, that is Katlakatla. Okay, so the body is deeply compressed and the dorsal profile is more convex than the ventral. Okay, here you see, this is the dorsal profile. Okay, this is the dorsal profile and this is the ventral profile. Okay, this is dorsal profile, this is ventral profile. If you compare, here you see, in the case of Megala, this is the dorsal profile, this is the ventral profile, is it? Or if you see the Rohu, this is the dorsal profile and this is the ventral profile. So if you see the dorsal profile and the ventral profile in Rohu, this is almost similar, is it? Jaisa curve idhar hai, waisa hi curve bottom mein bhi hai. Jaisa shape dorsal ya upper region ka hai, almost waisa hi shape bottom region mein bhi hai, is it? Then if you see in the Strenus Megala, the same. Jaisa aapka dorsal profile hai, the same way this is the your ventral profile. Jaisa upar ki taraf fish ka shape hai, waisa hi niche. But when you look into the katla, you just see there is a huge difference between the dorsal profile and the ventral profile. If you look, the dorsal profile looks more convex as compared to the ventral profile, is it? This is one of the diagnostic character of the katla. So the dorsal profile more convex than that of the ventral profile. Eyes are large, and if you hold the fish in your hand and try to see the eyes from the bottom, from low below side of the head, it is visible. Okay, so katla have very large eyes which are visible below the head. If you try to see the eyes of the fish below the hand, it will be visible. Okay, snouted blunt, mouth is wide, and position is superior because katla is a surface feeder. Okay, so it has a superior mouth position. Because it has a superior mouth, so the upper jaw is not, upper lip is not very prominent, but it have a very prominent protrudable lower jaw which have the movable articulation at the symphysis. Okay, then the lips are thick and unfringed. Unfringed means it doesn't have any muscular or covering or the layering. Okay, barbels are absent. Then dorsal fin is long and inserted above the tip of the pectoral fin. It means suppose from here the pectoral fin is started, na? So the dorsal fin is also started from here. If we talk about the katla, if this is the point of the insertion of the pectoral fin, so the dorsal fin also will start from this point. Okay, is it clear? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
So, dorsal fin is long and inserted above the tip of the pectoral fin. It has 17 to 18 rays. Okay. Then teeth are absent, but pharyngeal teeth are present. Lateral line scales from 40 to 43. Okay, then fin formula is 3 plus 50, dorsal 3 plus 15, pectoral 1 plus 18, pelvic 1 plus 9, and anal 3 plus 5. Okay, so this is the taxonomic position or the systematic classification of the Cathlacathla. So this is also seen, only the genus and species name is variable. So these are the diagnostic character of the three species that we have taken today: the Indian major calves, the Labia rota, and the Serinus regula. Okay, so it is clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You have to remember this character for practical as well as the theory examinations. We are supposed to conduct the end-term examination online in this month only. Okay, so be prepared. Okay. So there will be within a week the meeting will be conducted in the university, and within the week we will receive the guideline from the university. ICAR had already issued the guideline for the examination, but university have to take some decision at their own levels. University meeting will be in few days. Okay, the board of studies. So here where they will decide what will be the nil take on the examination. So examination will be there. What will be the mode or how you will be awarded the grades will be cleared in that, after that meeting only. So, but be prepared for the end-term examination in this month only. Okay. And it's going to be the online. Basically, it should not be the MCQ. It will be like a multiple choice question. Okay. It will be like short answers. Okay. So everyone have only one quiz before the midterm. You have the one quiz before the midterm, na? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, one quiz and an end term exam for theory and practical is remaining. Okay. So quiz, all the teachers will take in the online mode. Okay. MCQ type questions will be there for 5 marks. So shortly the quiz will be conducted, so be prepared. And for end-term theory and practical examination, it will also be very soon. So these diagnostic character which we have discussed today, it is important for theory as well as practical examination, because if there will be no way, because I don't think so even in the May or June we're able to open the college, because our college is now become this isolation center.
Quarantine center. Yes, ma'am.
And every day 5 to 6 buses are coming here. Okay. And within a 3 days, 9 COVID-19 positive case in the Kishanganj. So what will be the situation in the next 1 month? We don't know. Even if your district will be in the green zone, we are not going to be in green zone anymore for next 2 months. Okay. At least this campus is going to be become the containment center now. So it will be very difficult to resume the classes here. Even our office is totally shut down. We are confined in our flats only. We are not even able to roam around in the campus also. Okay. So I don't know when we are going to resume the college. The exam will be in online mode only. So be prepared for that. A practical exam will also, if the practical exam will be online, so it will be kind of MCQ or short answer type question. So be prepared for all those things. Okay. Syllabus almost sara complete ho gaya hai.
Yes, ma'am.
Jo thoda bahut bacha exam se pehle, teachers will complete all those topics. Okay. So ye clear hai tino diagnostic character of Labia rota, Cathlacathla and Serinus regula?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will now take the diagnostic character of Clarus batricus. Okay. So any query from the previous three fishes? Anyone? Any confusion? No, okay, so we'll take the diagnostic character of Clarus batricus. Okay, so the very first character, it has a broad and a flat head, elongated body which tapers toward the tail, means which is become tape like at the end. Okay, or the it becomes compressed slowly when we move towards the posterior end. As you know, the Clarus batricus is a catfish. Okay, so the catfishes, why they got the name catfishes, because they have very prominent barbels. Okay, viscous means a prominent long hairy barbels. Okay, so here the long, prominent and long barbels, whiskers means, okay. So this Clarus batrachus have four pair of barbels, which are whiskers and fleshy. Means their texture is fleshy. The barbels are fleshy. Okay, then papillated lips, teeth, because they are carnivorous fishes. Okay, so teeth are villiform, which occurs on the patches on the jaw and the palate. Then maxillary barbels reach to the middle or base of the pectoral fin. Mandibular barbels are shorter, eyes are small. And the dorsal fin, it is continuous and extended along the back, okay, 2/3 of the length of the body, and there will be no dorsal spine, okay. So if you see this fish, the dorsal, caudal and anal fin, if you see, it looks almost continuous, okay, means when the dorsal fin ends, the caudal starts, then the when you turn down, then when the caudal ends, the anal starts. Okay, so here you see. From here, this dorsal fin starts like this. When dorsal ends, the caudal starts. When the dorsal the caudal ends, the anal starts. So if you see, from dorsal to the caudal to the anal, it is almost a continuous fin. Okay, so this is one of the diagnostic character of Clarus batrachus, and then pectoral spine is present. Okay, the pectoral spines means this pectoral fin here you see is, this is the spine. Okay, so the pectoral fin have a hard spiny very hard spine. Okay, so this spine have rough surface, the outer edge have a very rough surface, while the inner edge have the serration or small needle-like projections. Okay, outer surface is rough and the inner surface of the pectoral spine have serration or needle-like structure. Occipital process is more or less triangular. What is occipital process? Anyone? Anyone? Occipital process. Akanksha.
Mom.
Yes,
ma'am. Abhi yaad nahi aa raha, but pata hai.
Pata hai, because I remember you come to me in class with some occipital process. There is another girl. Uska kya naam hai? Shilpi. Shilpi is here.
Yes, ma'am.
What is occipital process? To me, one question related to the occipital process.
Ma'am, वो head region पे soft like this feel होता है touch करने में, उसी को बोलते हैं.
नहीं, उसको उस soft region को occipital process नहीं बोलते हैं, उसको groove बोलते हैं. This shape, this is known as the occipital process. This hard head bone structure is known as a occipital process. So this occipital process is triangular in shape here, you see. Okay, and the length, is it clear? What is occipital process? Is it clear now? So
yes, ma'am.
So the occipital process is more or less triangular and its length is about 2 times in its width. Okay, so that is one of the diagnostic character of the Clarus batrachus. Occipital process is triangular in shape and its length is about 2 times as compared to its width. And this is the fin formula. The dorsal fin doesn't have any spine. Anal the hard rays, the anal fin also doesn't have any hard rays. Pectoral have one hard spine, and this is pelvic also have one hard spine. Okay, so this is the diagnostic character of Clarus batrachus. Okay, so this is the taxonomic classification. This is belongs to the order Siluriformes. Siluriformes is the order which represents the catfishes. Then the family Claridae, genus Clarus, and species batrachus. Okay, so this was about the today's class. So now we will take today the another economically important catfish, that is Pangasiodon hypothalamus. Okay, this is commonly known as Pangas, or in some pockets of Bihar it is also known as a Payas. Okay, Payas or Pangas is the local name of this species, Pangasiodon hypothalamus. This is an exotic species, means this is not the native of our country. The native species of this genus in our country is Pangasiodon pangasius and Pangasius pangasius. Okay? But the Pangasius species, which is common in the culture in our country, is Pangasiodon hypothalamus. And it is very it is very important species because it shares a huge market in India among the freshwater fish species. And then if you would, it is preferred in the group of consumers who likes spineless meat of the fish, okay, because this have the meat of the Pangasiodon doesn't have spines in the belly portions, okay. So, or in suppose most of the restaurants or the hotels which serve the preparations of fish meat or the fish flesh, they also prefer the Pangasiodon hypothalamus. The very first thing is the price, okay, because it is available in the less price. The second reason is that because the spines are less, so the preparations, okay, the mincing of meat, preparing different type of food, it's easier, okay. And if you come, there is the consumer preference always change from reason to reason. If you even if in your own Bihar, the few states prefer the smaller size of fish. If you go towards the Madhubani side, people prefer smaller size of fishes, okay. In some reasons, okay, the people prefer the larger fishes, large size of big, 2 kg, 3 kg, rohu, katla, mrigal, that is their preference, okay. Some reasons have, particularly like in Kishanganj, okay, consumer prefers this hypothalamus because here, the majority of the populations go for the flesh or the meat which have less spines, okay. So this species is culture is this species is cultured in entire India. Andhra Pradesh also have a very established fisheries or culture or aquaculture of this species. In Bihar this species is very popular. So today we will take the diagnostic character of this species. As I have told, this is a catfish. So the very first character of the catfish or the fishes which belongs to the order Siluriformes is scaleless fishes. Okay, so their skin is smooth, head small, body elongated. Now mouth is terminal, okay, but the upper jaw is slightly longer than the lower jaw, okay. And if we see the adult or the mature Pangasiodon hypothalamus, what we will see, it has a dark gray to black color body, okay, gray to the black color body, which have some reddish tinge on the fins, okay. And the dorsal fin rays are sixed, which are branched, okay. Then gill rackers are normally developed, which have some means the gill rackers in most, if in other species, if you go to the calves, what you see, the gill rackers are present, okay, on gala, they are of uniform size. But if we talk about the Pangasiodon, it have some peculiar morphology that some gill rackers are small, then after regular intervals, there is a large small gill rackers, followed by the small gill rackers, then a patch of larger ones, okay. So that is characteristic of the Pangasiodon hypothalamus. Then the young ones or the young fishes or the smaller fishes, they have the black color strip along the lateral line, okay, along the lateral line, and one strip below the lateral line, okay, means it have two black strip. One runs along the lateral line and one below the lateral line, okay. But in the that is in the young stages, okay. In adult stages, the entire fish is uniformly gray in color, okay. Then the anal fin, it have a middle black color strip Even the caudal lobe also have the black color strip. Okay, we'll see in the figure. You just see, this is the adult hypothalamus. Okay, pangasiodon hypothalamus. This is the anal fin. This is the caudal fin. If you see in the anal fin, there is a black strip. Okay, and here also. So this is the taxonomic classification. It belongs to the order Siluriformes and the family. This is pangasiodon, and this is hypothalamus. The diagnostic character of another species, Hypothalamicus molitrix. Which species ka scientific name hai animal?
Silver carp.
Silver carp. Okay.
Silver carp.
Silver carp. This is exotic carp species. It's not the native of introduced from other country in the our culture system. So this is also a economically important. Okay, so part of the polyculture, polyculture. So the character, the body is stout, compressed with uniform cell. You see the silverfish in the fresh. Okay, it have very shiny. Okay. This fish has a large mouth and superior mouth position, and jaws are formed. If I'm telling this, yeah, microphone off karo, kiska on hai, bahut awaaz ho rahi, birds ka bahut. Shilpi, please microphone off. Okay, so I was at mouth position. Okay, this fish has a large mouth which is slightly superior. This fish have a superior type of mouth. So if this fish have a superior type of mouth, means it feeds in which surface? In which region of the pond, if it has a superior mouth? Bataye. If a fish have a superior mouth.
Upper surface.
Okay, the outer surface. So this is a surface feeder, plankton feeder. It used to have a plankton, basically phytoplanktons. They feed karte hain on surface. They are surface feeder. So that is why they have the superior large mouth. Okay. Because they are cypriniformes, so jaw is toothless, but they have the pharyngeal teeth, which is present in one row. Okay, then a very important diagnostic character of the Hypothalamicus molitrix is that the dorsal fin is originated behind the pelvic fin. Okay, so the dorsal fin is situated very behind. Okay, even pelvic fin ke baad. The number of dorsal fin rays is 8. And because they are the filter feeders, okay, they feed on the planktons. That is why their gill rakers are fused to form a sponge-like porous plate, which basically help in filtering the food or the plankton when the water passes through the gills. Okay, they have very small, minute scales and no barbels. The lateral line is complete, but it is curved on the ventral side. Okay, means niche ki taraf आके वो curved हो जाती है, which have 83 to 124 scales on lateral line, and this is the fin formula. Here you can see that. Just see, this is the start of the pelvic fin, and the dorsal fin is behind the pelvic fin. Okay, this is pelvic, and if you draw a straight line to the pelvic, the insertion of the dorsal fin is behind the pelvic. Okay, and then here you can able to see this lateral line. It is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The lateral line, which actually start curving when you moves towards the ventral side. Ventral side means niche ki taraf. Okay. So these two are the diagnostic character. Here, this is the superior mouth. The characteristic of the superior mouth is the upper lip is less developed or indistinct, and the lower lip is highly developed. Okay, so this is some of the diagnostic character of the silver carp or the Hypophthalmictis molitrix, and this is the taxonomic position of this species. This species belong to the order Cypriniformes. Spelling galat hai. Cypriniformes hoga, di nahi hoga. Okay, Cypriniformes, family Cyprinidae, genus Hypophthalmictis, and species molitrix. Okay. Now we will take another very important species, that is the Anabas testudinus. Have you heard the name Kawai? A common name?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Specific name of Kawai. Okay, Kawai is also known as a climbing perch. Okay, because this species can climb on trees. Okay. Climb on trees means this species has the accessory air breathing organ. Means this, when this species is in water, it respires through the gills. But if it is on the land or the when water is just on the water, the hypoxic at the water means dissolved oxygen in the water is less. So this fish can come outside the water and it breathes with the help of the accessory respiratory organ. Okay, so this species have the accessory respiratory organ. Okay, it can walk even on surface just because it can respire through the accessory respiratory organ. Okay. So this fish belongs to the order Perciformes. If you have already gone through the characteristic of different orders, important orders like Cypriniformes, Siluriformes, Perciformes, Symbranchiformes, okay, Alopiformes. So, in what is the diagnostic character of the order Perciformes?
Tenoid scales.
Tenoid scales. Uske lava? The very important character of the order Perciformes is the fish's bears scales on head region. Okay, if you have seen the fishes of the Cypriniformes, their body is entirely covered with the scale except the head region. Okay, head region doesn't have any scales. If you see the fishes of the order Siluriformes, they doesn't have the scale on the entire body. But if you look for the fishes of the order Perciformes, what you will find, their body is covered with the scale, including the head. Means head also have the scales. Okay, so that is, and so because this species belong to the order Perciformes, so the body is laterally compressed with the scales on the head. Okay, mouth is anterior, or we can say that this terminal, and the lower jaw is slightly longer. Okay, then it has a villiform teeth which is present on the jaws, long dorsal and anal fin. Okay, the dorsal fin and anal fin are comparatively long if we compare it with the fins of the other orders like Cypriniformes or Siluriformes, and the pectoral and caudal fins are rounded. Okay, when if you must remember when we were studying the different type of caudal fin shapes. Okay, that time you have studied the forked, then deeply forked, truncated, rounded. Remember? Okay, so this species have the rounded caudal fin. Okay, pectoral and caudal fin both are rounded. Okay, and the dorsal, pelvic, and anal fin raised. Okay, when you would examine the fish fin in the practical class, you have seen the hard fin raised and soft fin raised, is it? Huh? So here in this Anabas testudinus, the hard fin rays are modified into the spines. Okay, and the scales are tenoid. The tenoid scales are the characteristic of the Perciformes. So the Anabas testudinus have the tenoid scales. Lateral line interrupted. Lateral line interrupted means it start from the upper collar bone. Okay, and then in between it get interrupted. It means it just end in between. In mid of the body, okay, and then after some space again a lateral line starts. Okay, so means there is a lateral line if you see from head to the tail, but that lateral line is interrupted in between. Okay, so this species have interrupted lateral line, two lateral line. The first lateral line, which is towards head, have 16 to 17 scales on the lateral line, and the second lateral line, which is towards tail, have 11 to 12 lateral line. Okay, and this is the fin formula. So here we will see, this is the typical features of the Anabas testudinus. You just see there is a one lateral line here, it ends here and another starts here. Okay, and then you see here the dorsal fin is very long, it starts from here and it ends here. And just see the caudal fin is rounded. Caudal fin is rounded and even the pelvic fin is also rounded. Okay, the caudal fin is rounded, the pelvic fin is rounded, and then anal and dorsal fins are very long, and the hard rays, they are developed into the small spines. Okay, and this region have the soft rays. Okay, and here the scales are also present on the head region. Okay, so this is the characteristic features of the Anabas testudinus. This species belongs to the order Perciformes, family Anabentidae, genus Anabas, and species testudinus. Okay, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, a question.
Yes, ma'am.
हाँ पूछिए.
मैम बहुत सारे हार्ड रेज मिलके एक स्पाइन बनता है या फिर स्पाइन वो सिर्फ एक ही डेवलप हो जाता है?
एक ही हार्ड और पॉइंटेड स्पाइनी हो जाता है. ठीक है.
यस ओके मैम.
ओके सो दिस इज वी हैव टेकन द सम ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कमर्शियल इकोनॉमिकल स्पीसीज ऑफ फ्रेश वाटर. नाउ टुडे वी विल आल्सो टेक सम ऑफ द स्पीसीज ऑफ marine fishes. Now I would like to ask from Akanksha. Akanksha, आपने अपना profile में एक picture लगाई है, ठीक है?
Yes, ma'am.
क्या है वो? हाँ?
क्या ma'am?
Akanksha, you have one.
आपका ये जो आपने?
आपका जो zoom का profile है, आपने एक fish की image लगा रखी है.
Yes, ma'am.
किसकी image है वो?
Yes, ma'am.
कौन सी फिश है वो? ये बस अच्छी लग,
तो नहीं पता है, बस ऐसे
अच्छी लगी इसलिए लगा दी.
मैम
हाँ
हाँ अच्छी लगी बस. हाँ अच्छा, अच्छी लगी,
अच्छी लगी इसलिए लगा दी. कोई और उसके अलावा कोई और रीजन नहीं था? हाँ अच्छा. एनीवन
नहीं, और कोई रीजन?
जितने भी लोग अभी क्लास अटेंड कर रहे हैं जरा उसमें पार्टिसिपेंट लिस्ट में जाइए एंड सी द आकांक्षा प्रोफाइल पिक्चर्स. कोई बता सकता है ये किस फिश का स्केच है?
मैम डॉल्फिन.
डॉल्फिन
मैकरल.
अच्छा
हेलो. डॉल्फिन मछली नहीं है रे.
हेलो यस बोलिए.
क्लास मैकरल फिश.
डॉल्फिन बोला उसको मैंने, यही से रिमूव करने का ऑप्शन है मेरे पास. ठीक है चलो बताओ. एनीवन
मैकरल
प्लीज. अच्छा ये बताओ, आज मैंने मटेरियल भेजा था, एनीवन हैव गॉन थ्रू दैट मटेरियल? कोई है? ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है सबने देखा हो. कोई है जिसने उस स्लाइड्स को एक बार खोल के देखने की जहमत उठाई?
क्यों ना फिश.
हाँ? कौन है पहले नाम बताओ.
शार्क.
पता नहीं क्या बोल रहे
हो. नस अल्बेकस.
क्या?
ट्यूना.
ट्यूना दिस इज द स्केच ऑफ ट्यूना. ओके सो द इमेज व्हिच हैव यूज्ड बाय द कांशा इन द प्रोफाइल इज बेसिकली द स्केच ऑफ द ट्यूना. There are different types of tuna like yellow fin tuna, blue fin like tuna, big eyed tuna. Okay, there are several species. This is basically a sketch of the tuna. Okay, so today we are going to some very commercially important fishes. Okay, because the tuna fisheries or the mackerel fisheries, this is a very important economical fisheries of our country. Okay. So these are the fishes which comes through the capture fishery. Now anyone can tell me what is capture fishery and what is culture fishery? कैप्चर फिशरी एंड कल्चर फिशरीज
मैम अगर
यस बोलो वर्तिका
यस मैम अगर मैम हम लोग मतलब कि उसके सारे मतलब कल्चर करते हैं खुद से उसको उसका फीडिंग हैबिट एंड ऑल दीज जो है वो खुद के मैनेजमेंट से करते हैं मतलब हम लोग उसका टोटली ध्यान रखते हैं उसके स्टार्टिंग फेज से लेके उसके लास्ट तक फेज तक तो वो
कैप्चर फिशरी ओके
हो जाएगा और अगर मतलब उतना हम लोग ध्यान नहीं देते मतलब मैनेजमेंट हम लोग का उतना ज्यादा नहीं रहता है उसपे तो वो
मैनेजमेंट रहता है कैप्चर फिशरीज में उतना ज्यादा मैनेजमेंट से व्हाट यू मीन उतना ज्यादा मैनेजमेंट
मैम मतलब उसका टोटल हैबिट हम लोग के अंडर रहता है मतलब फीडिंग हैबिट एंड
एक्सटेंसिव और इंटेंसिव कल्चर बोल रही हूँ शायद
नहीं मैं कल्चर और कैप्चर की बात कर रही हूँ यू हैव टोल्ड कल्चर फिशरीज मीन द फिशरी वेयर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द फिश स्पीसीज इन द मैनेज्ड Is it? That is culture fisheries, okay? And if I'm talking about the capture fishery means the fish or the fishes or the,
all kinds of
जिसमें कि हम natural resources जो है वहां से fish को catch कर रहे हैं We are not breeding, we are not feeding them, okay? हम कोई उसमें कुछ भी नहीं कर रहे हैं We simply वो natural resources जो उसको हम सिंपली कैच कर रहे हैं और कैच करके फिर उसकी जो भी प्रोसेस है मार्केटिंग की जो भी है वो सारा कर रहे हैं ठीक है सो दैट इज द कैप्चर फिशरी सो द टुना फिशरीज और द मैक्रेल फिशरी इज कैप्चर कम द फिशेस दे आर द मेन और द इकोनॉमिकली इम्पॉर्टेंट स्पीसीज ऑफ द कैप्चर फिशरीज ऑफ अवर कंट्री ओके सो आपका ये जो फिशेज हैं ये हमारा जो कोस्टल जोन है उधर जितने भी आपका सी है चाहे अरेबियन सी है चाहे इधर इंडियन सी है इन सी में ये जो दो स्पीसीज है टुना और मैक्रेल इनका फिशरी बहुत सारी है इंडियन ऑयल सार्डिन है मिल्क फिशेज है बॉम्बे डक है देयर आर सेवरल स्पीसीज इनका फिशरीज बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है बट मैक्रेल फिशरी एंड टुना फिशरी दे आर अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्पीसीज ऑफ द capture fisheries today we will first take the tuna okay so this is the diagnosis of today we will discuss the diagnostic character diagnostic character of a species Thunnus albicaus okay anyone can tell me what is the name of this common name of this species Thunnus albicaus
yellowfin tuna
this is the Indian Ocean yellow fin tuna okay so today we will see what are the diagnostic character so the diagnostic character when we talk about the marine fishes particularly this species belongs to the family scombridae okay scombridae mein jo sabse important diagnostic characters hote hain aap dekh rahe hain yahan mein do fins hai particularly they have two dorsal fin first dorsal fin and सेकेंड डॉर्सल फिन उसके बाद अब यहाँ में कुछ देख रहे हैं ना दिस इज रुडिमेंटरी फिन विच इज नोन एज द फिनलेट्स ओके आपकी डॉर्सल रीजन पे भी है आपकी वेंट्रल रीजन पे भी है यानी डॉर्सल फिन के बाद कॉन्टिन्यूएशन में भी है और एनल फिन के बाद भी कॉन्टिन्यूएशन में भी है तो डॉर्सल फिनलेट्स कितने हैं और एनल फिनलेट्स कितने हैं दिस इज द डायग्नोस्टिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्पीसीज ओके ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द फिनलेट्स वी कैन differentiate the different species okay so here the body these are some of the diagnostic character the body is fusiform slightly compressed on lateral position lateral side then the total gill rachor on the first gill are varies from 26 to 34 there is a two dorsal fins first dorsal fin second dorsal fin and these two dorsal fin is separated by a narrow interspace means there is only small space between these two fins the first dorsal fin and the second dorsal fin then this dorsal fin is followed by 8 to 10 finlets 8 to 10 rudimentary fin or finlets means the second dorsal fin followed by the 8 to 10 finlets and the anal fin is followed by the 7 to 10 finlets okay And if we take the large specimen of tuna, yellowfin tuna, so it have very long second dorsal and anal fin. The large specimen have a long second dorsal and long anal fin, okay, which is almost 20% of the fork length. Fork length, kaun si length hogi? The length which is start from here to here. This is the fork length. So in the large specimen, the length of second dorsal fin or the anal fin reach up to the 20% of the total, up to the 20% of the fork length. Okay, then the pectoral fin, this is, okay, the pectoral fin is quite long. It reached beyond the dorsal, second fin dorsal origin, okay, and it is usually 22 to 30% of the fork length. The length of the pectoral fin is 22 to 31% of the fork length. Okay, so this is some of the diagnostic character of yellowfin tuna. So then it have two flap between pelvic fins. Okay, which is also known as the interpelvic process. Then body have small scales. The caudal peduncle is very slender and bearing the keel, a strong lateral keel here. Okay. At this, there is a small hardy structure which is known as a keel. So basically it have three keels, two smaller keels on both sides, and in between a large, prominent, strong keel. Okay. Then the color is metallic dark blue, okay, which change through yellow to silver when we move from dorsal and towards the belly, okay. And there is some broken vertical lines, okay. Vertical lines means aise, vertical matlab dorsal se ventral ki taraf aa rahi ho. Aise vertical lines are also present, okay. And the dorsal and anal finlets are bright yellow in color, which have the black borders. So this is the image. Yes.
Ma'am, what is the function of keels?
Keels, it basically supports, this is a skeletal part of the skeleton. It supports locomotion. Okay. Basically.
Okay.
So this is the taxonomic classification of the Thunnus albicans, the order Perciformes, family is Combridae, genus Thunnus, and species albicans. This is the yellowfin, Indian yellowfin tuna. Here you can see this broken vertical lines on the body of the species. Okay, these are the dorsal finlets, anal finlets, then caudal keel. Large pectoral fin, two dorsal fins, okay. Then upper ka jo color hai, that is metallic blue when you move towards belly from blue to yellow and then yellow to silvery white, okay. So this is the taxonomic, these are the taxonomic characters of the yellowfin tuna. Now the Indian mackerel. Restelligus carnagouta, okay. This is the scientific name of the Indian mackerel, Restelligus carnagouta. Anyone can tell me the national fish of our country? Which species is the national fish?
Mackerel.
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 Indian mackerel. Yes.
Indian mackerel.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the Indian mackerel is the national fish of our country. So we are going to see the diagnostic characters of the Indian mackerel, Restelligus carnagouta. So this is even mackerel humne ki lab mein, have you seen specimen jar mein?
Yes, ma'am.
And usme bhi displayed the Restelligus carnagouta. So this is the species which have the moderately deep body, okay, and its margin is depth, body depth here, circulum, which is 4.3 to 5.2 times in the dorsal length, okay. Then head is longer than the body depth. Then it has a very well-developed adipose islets. Gill rack is very long. Even if you open the mouth, you can able to see the gill rack, which is situated on the gill earth. So there is 30 to 46 gill rackers on the lower limb of the gill, and it have a moderate number of bristle or the longest gill rackers. Okay, then it also have a two dorsal fin, same like tuna. They have two dorsal fin, which are widely separated. Okay, in tuna you have seen they have very small means gap between two fins, first dorsal and second dorsal, but in Restalligus carnagota they are bifurcated. Okay, and the sixth dorsal fin and the anal fin have 5 to 6 finlets, followed by 5 to 6 finlets, and their color is black, blue, or green. Okay, which have some golden tint, some small dark spots. Basically, it have a lateral line, basically a strip, a long strip in the younger one. As the fish grows older, that line become broken and it appears as a dark spots. Okay, so you will find the dark spots on the body, a band, okay, or the upper part of the body. And this is the fin formula of this species. Here we can see that, just see. And this is the mackerel here, you see. This is the first dorsal fin. This is the second dorsal fin. And there is a huge difference between huge gap between the first dorsal and the second dorsal fin, which is followed by the 5 to 6 finlets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 finlets. The same way the anal fin is also followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 finlets. Okay. So this was the diagnostic characters of the Indian mackerel, Restalligus carnagota. So yellowfin tuna and this Restalligus carnagota, they both belongs to the order Perciformes, and the family is Combridae. So this species belong to the family is Combridae, genus Restalligus, and species carnagota. Now the another very important species of the Indian marine fisheries, or we can say that the capture fishery, that is the Bombay duck. Have you heard the name Bombay duck?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we are also going to take the diagnostic character of Bombay duck. The scientific name of the Bombay duck is Harpodon niharius. So this is the species, a very peculiar species. The 90% of the body is water. Okay. It's the water content in this fish is very high. That is why it in a fresh stage, okay, or in the live stage, this fish have the translucent or the semi-transparent appearance. Okay, so that is a very characteristic of this species. It have a translucent or the semi-transparent appearance because a very high content of water in their body, and scales are present, but they are not covering the entire body. Okay. The scales are present in some trunk region and in caudal region only. Okay. Then dorsal fins, fin rays are 12 to 13 in number. Lateral line scale or pores, okay, it varies from 44 to 47. Then pectoral fin is long with 9 rays. And the gill arc is specialized. Okay. They have a different gill arc, which is known to this particular group of fish only, not in any other teleosts. Then the pelvic fin is with 9 rays. There is no spines in the fin. Adipose fin is present in this species. The fish is translucent or brownish, we can say. Nares are 2 in pairs. Nares means the nostril. Here you can see. Yeah, dekhe, do holes, small holes, dekhe, arrow position pe, jo arrowhead hai.
Yes, ma'am.
This species have 2 pairs of nares or nostril. Ek is taraf hoga, ek dusri side mein hoga. Okay. So this is the image of the Bombay duck. You can see that. This is yahan pe doll. Yahan pe image mein clear nahi hai. Here is the adipose fin. Yahan par hai. This is dorsal fin. This is pectoral. This is anal. Okay, so this species belongs to the order Allopiformes, the family Cynodontidae, the genus Harpodon, and the species Niharius. Okay,